Welcome to ManageEngine's webinar. I'm Varsha, and I've been working for ManageEngine Applications Manager for 4 years now, and I've been actively involved in various marketing activities, and I've also assisted customers in implementing our application performance management solution in their organizations. The topic of today's session is ensuring superior customer experiences on your website with real user monitoring. Before we begin, let's take a look at the agenda for today's session. So right off the bat, we're going to be talking about the need for real user monitoring, ways to implement insights gained from real user behavior, followed by leveraging the combined benefits of synthetic and real user monitoring. We'll then discuss steps to troubleshoot slow front-end performance and how Applications Manager can help improve real user experience. Let's get started. The advent of the pandemic has completely changed the way we look at life, personally and professionally. Everything has moved online and the digitization has taken over our lives. In fact, a report by McKinsey states that we vaulted 5 years forward in the consumer and business digital adoption in a matter of just around 8 weeks. Alarming, right? As businesses try to return to normalcy, they will need to confront the structural changes that are playing out. Customer behaviors and preferred interactions have changed significantly, and while they will continue to shift, the uptick in use of digital services is here to stay, at least to some degree. In fact, a report by McKinsey states that 75% of people use digital channels for the first time, indicate that they will continue to use them even when things return to normal. With Forrester also predicting a 40% increase in digital customer service interactions, organizations need to ensure that digital channels are at par or at least better than that of their competitors in order to succeed in the new environment. Now, these above facts reinstate the fact that our lives revolve around applications now. Banks have transitioned to remote sales and service teams. Grocery stores have shifted to online ordering and delivery as a primary business. In fact, due to the third wave, in the city that I live in, even schools have moved to hybrid mode, with half the students attending classes online and with half of them physically being present at school. Name the service and you can find it online. The reality is that now the new competitive battlefield is digital, and the winners and losers are defined by the experience that they provide. Any issues like website errors, crashes, payment failure, etc., will result in loss of customers, revenue, and ultimately damage a brand's reputation. Now, let's take a look at what Gartner has to say when it comes to application performance monitoring. So Gartner describes three main functional dimensions for the same. The first is digital experience monitoring, followed by application discovery, tracing, and diagnostics. Then comes AIOps for applications. So as you can see the order, user experience is the first. So if your users are facing any issues, then there is likely to be a problem in the application's end. So you'll be supposed to discover those applications, trace the dependencies, and diagnose the issues. Now, AIOps, as everybody knows, helps automate these troubleshooting of these issues and help you resolve it before the end users are impacted. Now, how do you measure end user experience? Let us consider an example. Imagine visiting a website that takes more than 10 or say 2 seconds to load. We know that the mouse is going to hover over the top right corner, because honestly, nobody has the time to wait nowadays. A study by Google confirms that speed and bounce rate are closely related. When the speed of your website slows down, the bounce rate continues to go up. At 1 second to 3 second loading rate, the bounce rate increases by 33%. And if it goes from 1 second to 3 second, then the bounce rate increases to 90. Now, if you're unaware of the performance and the steps that are needed to improve it, you could face high bounce rate that damages sales. And this is the level of impact of problem in one of these three basic dimensions, that is availability, functionality, and speed, can cause. But in order to ensure flawless performance, it is important to move beyond these three basic dimensions. Like just yesterday, I was trying to transfer money via net banking and I wasn't receiving my OTP. This was in spite of clicking resend several times. Now, this led to moments of panic before I realized that the problem was with my network provider. Now, if the bank were aware of the downtime on the telecommunication provider's side, I would have probably been notified by the bank that the service provider for my network is down and I could have received my OTP to my email. This could have saved me from an episode of panic and I wouldn't have assumed that there is a problem in the bank. This was just the regular scenario, but the stakes would have been much higher if the transaction was for an emergency. Now, when it comes to application performance monitoring or management, designing the best tools and techniques can get real complicated real fast. That is why it's helpful to remember the ultimate purpose of APM. The ultimate purpose of APM is simply to determine two things. First, how your end users are actually experiencing your website or mobile application. Second, how such data can be translated into actionable insights to achieve DevOps and business goals. And to get as close as possible to hitting both these criteria, there might be no better starting point than adopting an approach that incorporates real user monitoring using a performance monitoring tool. Now, what exactly is real user monitoring, aka RUM? Real user monitoring is a passive technique that helps collect and report data from the site actual users. It is a service that collects performance data passively from end user browsers, and then they connect to a website or a web service and create reports based on the visitors' interactions with the page. Real user monitoring provides information regarding the performance of the web page depending on the end user environment variables, including location, device, operating system, browser, and all of these information will help improve user experience. Now, when we talk about real user monitoring, there is one parallel that comes to mind, right? Google Analytics. Now, Google Analytics and real user monitoring are quite different, even though they may seem similar. Google Analytics passively monitors a certain spectrum of interactions between users and a website, such as page views, click paths, browser versions, and traffic sources, and delivers report accordingly using broad user averaging and data sampling algorithms. Google Analytics can help provide a high-level insight into site performance. A system administrator for whom website performance is a full-time monitoring job requires a real user monitoring tool. For them, a specialized RUM software is generally required to determine the response times and availability 24/7 and to drill down to the depth of detailed multi-tier analysis that more basic tools cannot. So what exactly makes a RUM software stand out? First and foremost, a real user monitoring software focuses on analyzing site performance from a user's perspective. Secondly, it helps you tackle high resolution data. RUM solutions usually employ injection of small bits of JavaScript code to monitor the client-side experience and identify key information about the user. These key events include DNS resolution, TCP connection time, SSL encryption, OS, network latency, etc. Now let us take a take a look at the steps involved in RAM. Let us consider a D2D example. Say you have to make an online payment of $100. How does that process work? You provide your card details and the information is then securely passed on to the payment gateway. These are the integration type. Then the payment gateway encrypts the card details and goes through a security check before the card information is sent to the acquiring bank. Then the bank sends the information securely to the card schemes and the approval or decline message is sent back to the payment gateway. Now, based on the message from the payment gateway, the merchant may either display the order or payment confirmation page or ask the customer to retry with different methods. Now, what seems like a 5-second process involves so many factors that needs to be on point in order to ensure a flawless experience. Now, realism monitoring can help examine the ease of use of interaction in cloud, mobile, and web applications. It allows the capturing of live sessions and monitoring of user experience across several tiers. Now, let's take a look at the steps involved one by one. Now, step one is data capture. It captures details about requests for pages, JSON, and other resources from browser to web servers, even when the requested content is hosted on other sites. Step two is sessionization. The captured data is then regathered into a recording containing pages, components, and timing information of each visit. Step three is problem detection. Any unusual behavior, such as slow response times, system problems, web navigation errors, and other malfunctions are analyzed for different pages, objects, and visits. Step four is individual visits. Now, the captured data is used to recreate the individual visits. With some applications, we can see exactly what the user saw. With others, we can see the summary of the data. Step five is reporting and segmentation. Now, this aggregated data can be used to identify page availability and performance across different browsers and user segments. Last but not the least, alerting. Now, the system will help activate an alert mechanism whenever a serious issue is spotted. Now, the best part about RAM is that it doesn't just provide an overview of how the user has interacted with the service, but also everything from which links were clicked to how long someone hovered their mouse over a specific image. Now, this technology can help you pull back metrics such as list of URLs visited, type of browser used, geographic details, OS, etc. For example, if there was an issue in signing in or payment and the user is unable to pay or sign up due to an error in the form, replaying the interaction will help identify and correct the issue. Now, let us consider another real-time scenario. Now, when you have a website, you're bound to have pages that are performing poorly, right? So how can RAM help? Now, product managers without too much coding expertise can use dashboards provided by RAM tools in order to detect when the high priority pages are performing poorly and then allocate resources in an efficient way to solve this problem. Now, the development team can also use realism monitoring to troubleshoot problems caused by a deployment, narrowing down to the surface search by using filters. Now let's take a look at the benefits of RAM. First and foremost, RAM helps you understand how exactly your application is being used. It helps you see the performance of each application function as the end user does, not just within your data center. Thirdly, it doesn't require any scripting. Now, scripting can take a significant amount of time and resources, so it's a huge advantage. Fourthly, it helps ensure full visibility into application usage and performance, not just what was scripted. It helps you understand real geographic distribution of your users and the impact of the distribution on the end user performance. It helps you track the performance of your most important users, which is particularly useful in trading environments. So for all the benefits that RUM has, it does offer some limitations. First and foremost, you cannot benchmark with the help of RUM. RUM is unable to examine your competitors' websites. This means that benchmarking your site's performance against others is very difficult. Secondly, the effectiveness in pre-production settings is limited. Now, it's not like RUM does not work in pre-production settings. It works just fine. But most customers simply don't have a lot of traffic in those settings. Thirdly, some users complain that sifting through the sheer amount of data that RUM provides can be really daunting, even for some using the better package tools in the industry. So what are the best practices of RUM? First, it can help you assess the current speed of the website. Faster websites lead to higher customer engagement. So paying attention to load data time is key. Second, you need to identify and track specific objectives. Now, doing this enables you to align those objectives with business goals. For example, we can set and track performance to target, like say, increase conversion rate from 10 to 12%. Third, you can relate the performance to the business. Now, real user monitoring should start with business goals and then flow down to tell how well the current system are performing when compared to the previous system. Now that we have seen how real user monitoring works, let's take a look at synthetic transaction monitoring. Now, real user monitoring is a passive monitoring method, whereas synthetic transaction is active. Now, synthetic monitoring emulates end-user transactions using behavioral scripts to validate and measure workflow performance from multiple test points. This kind of monitoring is well suited for resolving issues because it detects slowness or downtime before the end users notice any impact. Now, synthetic monitoring systems continuously collect performance measures such as response time or load time. Now, let's take a look at a few questions that synthetic monitoring helps answer. So with the help of synthetic monitoring, you can know if your website is up, if your transactions are working, if your third-party components are performing well, or if there is a slowdown or failure, where exactly is it? Now, let's take a look at the benefits of synthetic transaction monitoring. First and foremost, it is important for you to understand that synthetic testing is pre-configured for simulation, meaning that the traffic is manually generated to monitor the performance of a website or an application with the help of controlled set of variables such as geography, network, device, or browser. Now, this can be especially useful for exercising areas of the application that experience less traffic or identify problems arising from less commonly used geographies, networks, and browser types. You can use these synthetic tests to replicate multiple user journeys, meaning that potential performance issues can be identified before the end users are impacted. Now, synthetic monitoring can also be used to test websites and web applications in pre-production so that you can baseline the performance and set appropriate alert thresholds once an application or a website is live. As synthetic monitoring doesn't require embedding code snippets in the application or the website, users can easily connect all the metrics from synthetic transaction monitoring and set up benchmarks for their applications or website. For vendors, synthetic monitoring helps understand the availability and performance limitations of the application better. Armed with this data, vendors can set up realistic service level objectives and avoid unforeseen penalties. Last but not the least, you can hold your third-party vendors accountable. Synthetic monitoring enables the consumers of such third-party services to monitor service level objectives and performance degradations, and you can hold the vendors accountable for the same. Now that we've covered the benefits, let's take a look at the limitations. First and foremost, SCM will not help you resolve end user complaints. When service desk staff receive an end user complaint, synthetic monitoring products could tell them nothing about what the end user was actually doing or experiencing. It will not help you validate the impact of change across the estate. Now, when IT makes changes to devices, applications, or infrastructure, they must validate the impact of those changes on the actual end user experience to determine the actual impact. Comparing metrics from synthetic testing will not provide a full picture. Thirdly, creating and maintaining scripts for synthetic testing is time-consuming, even if it is for one application. Now, synthetic testing products lack this flexibility to troubleshoot devices. Now that we've covered the benefits and limitations of SCM and RUM, let's see if the limitations can be eliminated if SCM and RUM are used together. So how does the combination of SCM and RUM help? It helps correlate business with performance. Now, you must be well aware that synthetic monitoring can provide the performance data that will enable you to pinpoint problems with respect to page load time or say network bottlenecks. However, if you want to analyze exactly how web performance impacts business revenue, you need more than a synthetic performance metric. Since real user monitoring is generated to real user traffic, it provides insight into essential real business metrics, such as conversion rates, which can then be correlated with the continuous performance metrics collected from synthetic testing. Second, it can help you identify problems before the active users arrive. Now, no matter where your applications are hosted, problems are bound to occur, right? Synthetic testing is the most effective solution to identify a configuration problem caused by an off-hour maintenance so that it can be fixed before the users begin to use the website. On the other hand, real user monitoring would be most helpful to measure application responsiveness for each and every live user, even during peak hours. Third, it helps you troubleshoot outages with ease. Now, combining synthetic and RUM data can make troubleshooting quicker and easier. When synthetic tests fail or trigger an alert, data gathered from RUM will show you the real-time impact of the end-user experience. Similarly, if RUM data reveals a performance anomaly, then you can use synthetic to replicate the issue by exercising the same transaction across a number of ISPs and geographical locations. Now, collecting data this way allows you to triangulate from various vantage points to identify the root cause that may lie in the path between your end users and your application service. So using RUM and synthetic simultaneously, you can verify and deep dive into performance issues. Now, let us consider the scenario. By now, you must be clear that these technologies can be leveraged to track the path the data is taking from end users, branches, and other business locations to both on-premise and cloud-based services. Now, synthetic transaction monitoring helps simulate specific user transactions and gain step-by-step insight into performance of each interaction. RUM can help understand the real user journey by giving the best outcome. So this will help you identify time and location-based issues, thereby improving the overall user experience across geographies. Now that we've covered what RUM as well as SCM does, let's take a look at how you can troubleshoot front-end performance issues. So this typically comes in four steps. First, you diagnose the issue. Then you get the details of the diagnosis and prioritize them based on the impact. Measure how much impact that they have created. After this, it is very important to track the performance changes. You can view the performance trends via dashboards or reports and see the impact of such deployments. Then you can choose to drill down to specific metrics and check where you've had the biggest impact. Now you can compare these performance of the pages over a specific time period and ensure where there is a gain or where there is a loss. You can also track critical changes like reduced calls and time to load the assets. Now let me give you some tips to troubleshoot these issues. This is divided into three steps. First, you need to identify and diagnose the issue, take an action, and measure the impact of the action taken. Say, for example, you've diagnosed that the JavaScript or CSS is the root cause of the issue, and that is why some of your high priority pages are having high response time. And you've also identified the assets that are causing increased load time. So what action will you take? The action that you need to take is to reduce requests in order to improve the overall user experience. And this can be measured by checking the load time of each asset and checking for performance gain in terms of the pages. Now that we've covered how real user monitoring and synthetic transaction monitoring works, let me introduce you to our real user monitoring solution, which is Managed Engine Applications Manager. So we have been in the industry for the past 15 years, and we have been recognized in the Gartner Magic Quadrant for application performance monitoring for close to 9 times now. And we've also been recognized in the Gartner Peer Insights Customer Choice 2021. And we've been rated 4.5 out of 5 by Gartner. Applications Manager is an application performance monitoring solution that specializes in three categories. First being application performance monitoring with bytecode instrumentation, second being infrastructure monitoring, and third being digital experience monitoring. Now let's take a look at how we can use real user monitoring with Applications Manager. Now, the real user monitoring provided by Applications Manager will help you become aware of the user satisfaction, track the overall response time, and gain comprehensive insight into domain resources. It will also help you track key metrics like overall response time, DNS and connection time, redirection time, and more. It will help you assess your app dex code and determine if the digital experience is seamless or not. You can also monitor web application performance across different geographies. It will even help you isolate web transactions that are contributing to poor user experiences. Now let's take a look at the key features that Applications Manager helps you track. First is the app dex code. Now, app dex score is a user satisfaction score. It is calculated based on the response time of each transaction. Then comes the page load events and the HTTP requests. With the help of Applications Manager, you can monitor single page and multi-page applications. It will help you provide smart AI-powered alerts in order to let you know if there is an issue. It helps with sessionization and reporting. Now let's take a look at how this feature actually works in the product. Before that, you need to download the Real User Monitoring Agent for Applications Manager from our website. So you need to have an Applications Manager build of 15.390 and above in order to download it. So once you download it, you can go to the Real User Monitor here. And under copy script, you have the script that you need to copy inside your DOM agent in order to get it functioning. Now, this is a simple and one-time process. So you can track your own events and user traits from your web page by using this particular code snippet. This particular snippet acts as a beacon to all the user activities in your application. So once you install this particular snippet and get the RAM agent activated for your web application, then you can measure how it works. So here you can see various information such as ABDIC score, whether it is being satisfied, a tolerating, or if the users are frustrated. My score is 0.89 here. You can also view the total response time, which is 681 milliseconds here, and the page views and errors. The summary report will give you insight into ABDIC score, average response time, page views and errors. And you can also view the response time based on redirection time, DNS time, connection, server, first byte, document download time, page rendering, document rendering, and overall response time. Next, you have the page views and the throughput. Now, let me move on to the geographic tab. So as I told you before, real user monitoring can help you track the end user performance across geographies. Here, I'm from India, so it's tracking only the application performance in India, but you can track across several geographies. You can view the geographic summary up to 100 entries here, and you can view the ABDIC score, average response time, page views, and throughput for each location. Now we can also view the response time based on the internet service provider. So we can view the average response time, total count, and throughput. We can also sort this based on the browser. So here I have used it from three browsers, which is Chrome, Edge, and Firefox. We also support IE. You can view the browser usage as per split up. And the summary here. You can click on the particular browser in order to view the response time and throughput of it in detail. Next, you have the device time. You can measure the response time based on the device. For me, here it's just Windows, but you can measure it even for iPhone, tablets, PC, desktop, etc. So you can also view the top view report and the connection type and the device memory. In the device memory, you can view the response time and throughput of your device in detail. Now, Web Pages helps you track the web transactions, and this can be sorted based on average response time, total count, and throughput. Here I have less number of entries. When there are more number of entries, this particular sorting is very useful. Now let me click a transaction. Here you can view the average response time, ABDIC score, and the number of page views. You can also view the AJAX calls and the total count and throughput. Now moving on to the user sessions tab, you can see the average number of pages that have been navigated and the average viewing time, along with the total number of users and sessions. And you can also view the user sessions. And the split can be based on the browser, device, country, pages navigated, viewing time, etc. Next, you have the resources. So we help monitor three kinds of resources: first party, third party, and content delivery network resources. So you can click this button here in order to view which resource is occupying the most. For example, it's the image here, followed by others and CSS. You can view the same for CDN. Moving on to AJAX calls. As we saw earlier, when you click a particular transaction, you can view the AJAX calls as per response time and throughput details. Lastly, we have the JavaScript errors. So in case you have any errors, you can view the errors and pages and files here. So we are at the end of today's session. So, and we've received a few questions, I guess. So, which has been inserted by my panelists here. The first question is, how can I try the Real User Monitor? So, if you're new to Applications Manager, you can quickly download a 30-day free trial from our website and get started. Now, all the features are enabled in the free trial by default. You should be able to set up Real User Monitor for your website by following the steps in our help documentation. In case you're a customer of a product, you may simply reach out to a support team in order to enable a Real User Monitoring. Now, they will send you a trial license file in order to activate the RUM add-on in your APM build. So if you have any more questions, please feel free to put them in the chat panel. Our panelists will be happy to answer them for you. I think we have another question. What is the licensing model for RUM? So the RUM feature is basically account-based add-on. Each website that has RUM will be counted as one monitor agent. The price also depends on the page views metric. So these page views will have a monthly calendar limit, and you will be charged separately based on the tier you purchase. For example, the first tier starts at $65 for 1,000 page views per month. So we'll send you the link for the pricing in the chat panel so that you can have a look and decide as per your requirements. Thank you for attending today's session and taking the time out. In case you have any queries, you can reach out to me at devarsha.r@managingen.com. Thank you and have a nice day.